In this tutorial, I'll be showing how you can get a brand new Vue 3 and Vite app set up with continuous integration and deployed all within less than 5 minutes. Let's jump right in, shall we? Before we get started, let's check to make sure that we have what we need for the first section. We'll start by checking our node version by running the command node --version inside of your terminal. You'll see that I'm using version 16.13.0. Next, we'll want to make sure we have the latest GitHub CLI to make it easy for us to connect our project with our repo. And we can do that by running the command gh --version. You can see I'm using version 2.9.0. Now that we've gotten that taken care of, let's go ahead and create our brand new project. We'll do that by running the command npm create vite at latest, and then passing in the project name, which I'll call my first Vue app. Then we'll need to pass a parameter using the syntax --space --template --view. This is just a special syntax to make sure that we can actually interpret that we want to use the Vue template. Enter Y to proceed. And just like that, you're done. Now, let's go ahead and navigate into our project directory by running cd with your project name. So in my case, it's cd my first Vue app. Now that we have our project set up, let's go ahead and set up Git integration. We'll do that by running git init inside of the terminal that will automatically set up all the Git files you need to track version history in your project. Then, to create our repo, this is where we'll use the GitHub CLI, and we'll run the command gh --repo --create. When prompted on what kind of repo you want to create, select push an existing local repository to GitHub. Once you have that, let's go ahead and follow the prompts, path to local repository, the current directory, which is indicated by the period, is correct. Then the repository name, in my case, will be my first Vue app. The description, I'll go ahead and leave blank. Visibility will be public. And then just like that, we'll go ahead and make sure we add a remote for yes, and we'll leave the remote to be called origin. With all that set up, let's go ahead and push up our changes by running the command git add period, which will go ahead and add everything to staging. And then with that, we can go ahead and commit all the changes that we've added by running git commit -m for message. And then we'll write the message feature scaffold Vue 3 and Vite project. Once we run that, you'll see all the files that are committed. And then we can push it up to our repo by running the command git push origin main. With all that set up, it's time for us to deploy our app. We can do that by using the Netlify CLI, which will make our lives a lot easier. This assumes you have a free account already and you've logged in with Netlify CLI. To check to make sure that it's installed, you can run the command netlify --version inside of your terminal. Once you've verified that, all we need to do is run the command netlify init. When prompted, we're going to go ahead and create and configure a new site. And then you can decide what team you're going to put your site on. In my case, I'll put it in BenCodeZen's team. Next, the CLI will give you the option of determining what your unique site name will be. In my case, I'll go ahead and say that the site name will be My First Vue 3 App. Once you hit enter, you'll see that the site is beginning to be provisioned. Now let's go ahead and configure a few more things. You'll see that we have the build command here, which is automatically detected to be Vite build, so we can just hit enter. The directory to deploy is defaulting to dist. And then for the Netlify functions folder, we'll leave as default for Netlify/functions. And finally, for the Netlify toml, let's go ahead and create it by hitting yes. And then once you hit enter, you'll see that everything has been configured and it's working as you would expect. Before we go ahead and check to see how our site looks, let's go ahead and do one final thing in VS Code. Because we're running a single page application with Vue 3, we need to make one more configuration to make sure that everything is being deployed correctly when it comes to routing on single page applications. What you want to do is open up your netlify.toml, and you notice here in line 7 through 12 that there's already a commented section out for use with single page applications. So all we need to do is go into lines 9 through 12 and uncomment it and save it. Once we do that, we can go ahead and commit all the changes that we've made to our project so far. And we'll go ahead and run the command git add period and then git commit with the message of config add Netlify deploy files. And then we'll go ahead and push it up to our repo by running the command git push origin main. Once you do that, we can go ahead and actually open the site to see how it's deployed by running the command netlify open colon site. And there we have it. Here is our Hello World Vue 3 and Vite app deployed at the URL that we specified. In my case, myfirstvue3app.netlify.app. In addition, if you want to check how the deployment settings are working, you can do that by running the command netlify open inside of your terminal, and that will actually open up the Netlify dashboard for your site, where you can see all the different configurations that you have, check on the various deploys, and this is just the beginning. There's a lot more that Netlify has to offer when it comes to working with your site, and we look forward to sharing more with you in coming videos. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing what you build with Vue 3 and Vite.